university. And as I started thinking about this, I really see our nation as a whole has become so enamored with diversity that we have forgot what made this nation what it is, and that's unity. Unity of purpose, unity of thought and belief, and there's an importance there. There's a reason that we overcame the forces that try to destroy this nation in all the wars that we've been in, and all of the financial things that we've suffered, all the other issues that have worked against this nation surviving. It has been unity of purpose. You know, you talk to anybody that lived through World War II, and they say everybody was on the same page. It was win the war against an evil. And as we today, as we spend all of our efforts saying diversity, 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 we have forgotten that we are still one nation, under God, indivisible. And that means don't let that happen. Don't let that diversity be the watchwords. Let's be a nation that we work together. You know, you've probably all heard the buzzwords over the years, and a proactive and collaborative and all these other things. But today, the buzzword I'd like you to think about is ships. And that means ships of friendships, relationships, partnerships. That's what I think is lacking in this nation, and that's what's lacking in a lot of what we're talking today with the university. Take the time to develop friendships with all these people. They keep mentioning my name. Well, the only reason they do is because I've talked to Frank for the last 15 years, and we have a relationship. We have a friendship. All the things that we get done in business, and especially you young people, understand that relationships are the basis to success. Relationships is what it takes. When you can talk to a person by first name over and over again, when you can bring up a desire of what you would like to see, when you can think about, as a teacher, if you think about just your subject and say, I'm good at teaching this subject, but I don't really know and care about the student I'm teaching it to, you're not an effective teacher. So if you, as a teacher, understand who you're teaching and understand that their success is your primary importance, as a researcher, if you just want to do research without thinking about the people that that's going to affect and the benefit that you're going to provide in a larger scope, that makes that research valuable to all. So today, as we go out to view the farm, I want you to understand that there's a lot of work and effort that went to putting all that together and put those projects together, but they all came from relationships and people working with the researchers and working with corporations and working with producers and saying, what do you need research? What can we do out here? All of those projects out there took a lot of time and effort. I think you'll see we took a little mini tour. There's some really, it's really well taken care of. There's some good examples of stewardship out there. But while you're out there, I challenge you all to develop friendships and relationships. Talk to the person next to you. Talk to the other producers. Talk to these people from the university. Talk to those people and remember them and continue that relationship. And you can do almost an unlimited number of things. This building, the seed lab, the greenhouse, the hoop houses, the sprinkler irrigation system, all of that stuff came from relationships and constantly saying, coming back. Now, when you hear no, that means not today. That doesn't mean not tomorrow. It means keep bringing it up, keep thinking of different reasons why you need that, and keep justifying what you need, what you want, where you want to go, and eventually it'll happen. And it has happened here. And it's happened here because the University of Wyoming has an open ear to its producers. When they brought up the land-grant university, that's exactly what I wanted to focus on in my talk, is they are a land-grant university. They were developed to enhance the lives of and the profitability of all the people in the state of Wyoming. That doesn't just mean agriculture. That means homeowners. That means anybody that does anything in the state of Wyoming. They are there to help. They are there to support and enhance what we're doing. And that's why they have that founding, land grant founding. So develop those relationships. Remember to continually work towards a common unifying goal so together we can make things better. Together as agriculture producers, we need to understand that all the people that come together in our operation to provide fuel and insurance and banking and all the things that we deal with, if they prosper, we prosper. As a nation, if we all prosper, we grow stronger. So I'll just leave you with that. Thank you.